statement again of justification, sanctification.
That justification restores us to God's favor, that sanctification to his image.
Wow, I like that. That's good. I like everything you said, but that would resonate with me. I didn't say this, however, when Sister Rachel, you were talking there, you know, when we get down through the Beatitudes, he does, he said, you're the salt of the earth and you're the light of the world. So as we see these things being applied to us in our life of living sanctified, because it is about applying the righteousness of God to every area of our life, and really, when we look at that, there's a lesson for us to learn. And I skipped over a bunch of my notes because I get talking and don't pay attention to where I'm at. But that word happy, as Brother Justin said, blessed, the only way to really be happy is when we are holy. And folks may say, well, is it important for me to be happy? Isn't that the most important thing? No, God is, we shouldn't be pursuing happiness as much as we're pursuing the holiness of God. Because when we are in the image of God, as you said, Sister Rachel, when we pursue the image of God in his holiness, we will find that we will in turn really experience real happiness. And that only comes by being holy. And let me share another story with you. I'll never forget several years ago, some folks were going through some things with one of their children, and they were asked the question, and they were asked the question by other Christians, well, don't you want your child to be happy? And they responded back, I want my child to be holy. That is the way we should be pursuing life, not looking for happiness, but looking for holiness, because that in return leads to happiness. Blessed are they which are persecuted, because you're persecuted for righteousness. I'm not asking us to develop a 5-step program that we think will make us be holy, because our righteousness is as filthy rags. But I'm asking us to pursue God, that we pursue the image of God, Sister Rachel, as you said, that in return, his holiness becomes our image, and it creates real and lasting happiness, even if we're persecuted, even if we're misunderstood, even if we're ostracized. It's okay. I'm lost in the wholeness of God. And that's where I find my happiness. Hey, we're going to go to God in prayer tonight. I'm going to do like I